Hi, this is Andrew at 20i, and today we're going to be setting up a 20i mailbox in Apple Mail slash Mac Mail. So, setting up a mailbox within Mac Mail isn't particularly difficult. However, you may run into a few problems if you've never done so before, or if you're just a bit unsure on the settings that should be used. So, to begin with, you just want to make sure that you've opened Apple Mail on the macOS based device that we're doing this on. Once you've done that, you just want to go to Mail and Add Account. Once you've done that, you should then be presented with the following screen. Here, we just want to be selecting Add Other Mail Account. Once you've done that, just select Continue. Once we've done that, we should then be presented with the following form. The full name is simply the name that you wish to use on the device in question. So that can be whatever you want. It's not required for connecting to the actual mailbox. So we're just going to keep that as 20i. The email address will be the email address of the 20i mailbox. So here, for our video, we're just going to be entering test@20isupport.com. So that is literally just the name of the mailbox, whatever it is that you wish to connect to, that needs to be entered there. We're then presented with a password field. The password is just the password for the mailbox. So here, we're just going to enter the password for the test@20isupport.com mailbox. Once we've done that, we then just want to hit create. It should then attempt to discover the settings and should then say something akin to the account must be manually configured. Once it does that, we then just need to select next. Here, we're presented with another form asking if we want to use account types of IMAP or POP. We can use either, however, POP really isn't recommended nowadays. POP isn't particularly good for modern mail purposes in terms of if you're using the mailbox on multiple devices. POP generally will just download mail to that particular device or whichever device is able to sync with the mailbox first. So it essentially means you could have mail scattered all over the place, and we really don't recommend using POP for a 20i mailbox. For this video, we will be using IMAP. I should just note, if you do wish to use POP, the hostname that you need to enter here is pop.stackmail.com. However, as I say, we're using IMAP here. IMAP is much more preferred, essentially because IMAP allows you to sync mail across multiple devices, and is generally considered to be a more modern protocol for mail. So IMAP is the way forward here. So for the mail server for IMAP, we need to enter imap.stackmail.com. Once we've done that, we then just need to enter a username. Again, this is just the email address, so for our example, we're using test@20isupport.com. So that would just be your own email address. The password will just be the password for the mailbox again. This should be saved from the screen that we were previously on, so you shouldn't need to enter that again. If it's not there for some bizarre reason, then you just need to enter the password for the mailbox again. Once you're happy and we're all good to go, just hit next. Once you've done that, you should then be presented with this. This form is asking for the SMTP settings. SMTP settings are basically define who you send mail through. So SMTP is just defining which mail server you will actually be sending mail through. So for this, the SMTP server will be smtp.stackmail.com. The username here, and this is where these two fields often throw many people out. Both fields, both the username and the password field, say optional. These aren't optional, and these do need to be entered. If they aren't entered, then it will cause issues with the mailbox being able to connect. The username here will simply be the email address again. So for this, we're just going to use our example for the third time, test@20isupport.com. The password, again, is just the password for the mailbox, so we need to enter that. And once we're happy, and that's all good, we then just select Create. Once we've done that, we should then see the following. well, we should see mail from the mailbox within the left panel. That should then indicate that the mailbox has been set up. However, we do want to fiddle some additional settings. So from here, we just want to go to mail and preferences. Once we've done that, we can then see the settings for the mailbox and just double check that they're all okay. However, from here, we just want to go to advanced. Here, it should say we're using port 143 and hopefully user SSL should be ticked. If it isn't, we would recommend ticking that. When using SSL, we want to make sure that that's set to port 993. And then once that's done, we just need to click out and that should be good. That essentially means we're connecting over the secure SSL port of 993 for mail. Once we've then done that, we just want to edit the SMTP server so that it's doing the same, or at least setting the SSL port for it. So to do so, we just need to edit SMTP server list. So we go here, click, left click, or just click if you're using a mouse pad, and press edit SMTP server list. From here, it should then say account information and advanced. We just want to make sure we're hitting advanced. Thus, from here, we then just want to make sure that for the port, we're entering 465. And we just want to make sure that authentication is set to password. And then here, if it's not already pre-filled, you just want to, for the username, make sure you're entering the mailbox name again, and the password just needs to be the mailbox password. Once you're happy that's good to go, just press OK. So that should be the mailbox all set up if this video has been followed correctly. If you do encounter any problems with setting up the mailbox or you do run into any issues, please do get in touch with our support team and we can go through the settings with you and hopefully get you connected as needs be.